What's happening, people? And once again, welcome back to youtube.com/CubCamTV for this, another edition of Cub Reacts. But we are doing things a little bit differently today because we are getting into a full album review. That's right, we're going to be having a look at a very exciting album project. I'm going to let you know exactly what that is if you haven't read the intro to the video yet in just a couple of seconds. However, if you are new to the channel, please make sure you are hitting that subscribe button on the right-hand side of the page, turning notifications on, leaving a like, leaving a comment, and all of that good stuff. I've wanted to do more album reviews on the channel. Obviously, it's quite difficult working around copyright, playing like a full thing, doing like a live review. So we tend to focus on singles. Obviously, when I'm on radio, I'm able to do these sort of long, extended live album reviews, I suppose. And this is something we're going to bring to the channel in the sort of home setting. So we are going to get into this now. We are, of course, talking about Conscience's brand new album project, Red Rain. Really excited to talk about this. Just in general, I'm a big fan of Conscience and what he does. And obviously, we are in a position now where dancehall is in quite a good place worldwide. I feel the world seemingly has kind of re-accepted dancehall as a sort of powerhouse of a genre, and we're in a position where we're seeing a lot of global collaboration happening again. This is something we see throughout this album, actually. And I think first up, Conscience, especially over the last sort of 6 or 7 years or so, he's definitely been someone that has been at the top of his game. I've seen so many good tunes from him. I've seen such a consistent run of releases as well. He's definitely in his prime right now. And obviously, despite that, I still feel he's actually quite underrated, even though his consistency is absolutely through the roof. Two of my favourite dancehall tunes ever are Conscience tunes, so that might make me a little bit biased, I suppose. Hard Drive with Russian and Shensia is possibly my favourite dancehall tune ever. And obviously, Broke Off Your Back is in there as well. What an anthem that tune is. He's just released this album project. It's 18 tracks in length, which is always a little bit risky, especially in a sort of dancehall setting. It goes by the name Red Rain. And honestly, overall, I think the project is pretty solid, to be honest with you. We open up with a kind of toasted intro. As you can see, it goes by the name Season 4. And that is the intro to the entire album. Very sort of Latin-style guitars coming into the background on this one. And it sets the tone for the project very, very nicely. Again, quite stripped back, quite minimal, and it does get things going very, very well. Now, following on from this, we get straight into one of the main features of the project. So he launches with a very solid feature, which is, of course, with Stefflon Don, Mirror. Now, the visualizer for this one is up on his YouTube channel now, so you can check the full visualizer. It's a great tune. I think they work very well in collaboration. I think both of their voices complement each other when they're going back to back on a tune. And it's a pretty stripped back instrumental as well. So we get to see kind of the pair of them really work well in unison. From here, we move into Gunhead, and this is a very sort of rave-inspired anthem. A lot of auto-tune going on, some gritty bassline action beneath as well, and very punchy drums. It gives some real energy for the dance. And then we move into another track next, before Want to Love explores a more abstract and spacey style of arrangement. Now, this is, again, Conscience trying something a little bit different, which you're supposed to do on an album, but I feel this is quite a brave move, obviously, coming out of a very rave-heavy tune, and then moving into another top quality collaboration, which is, of course, Boom Bang, alongside the magnificent vocal sounds of Davido. If you follow this channel, you'll know that we are big fans of what Davido does vocally. I think he is one of the most sort of gifted vocalists in the world currently, and I love the fact that he is collaborating with so many people at the moment. This one is a bit of a DJ special, to be honest with you. It's a tune that I know DJs absolutely love to run, and it's a great link up in general. The back and forth is good. It's a very catchy hook. It's a tune that I've been supporting on The Breakfast Show quite heavily as well, so I'm obviously quite a big fan of this one. Moving into the next one, it goes by the name It's Cold. Again, a solid collaboration, but for me, one of the more forgettable tunes on the album project, a theme which I'll discuss a little bit later on. This isn't taking anything away from the tune itself. It's just wedged between two very big international collaborations. Obviously, Boom Bang with Davido, and then Pay For It with Spice and Russian. I've already said how much I like what Russian does, and Spice, realistically, is one of the biggest female artists in the world. So it's a difficult place for that collaboration to be for Dre Island. It's fine, but it isn't a standout tune for me, in all honesty. However, Pay For It, for me, is one of the, it's one of the sort of post-dancehall tunes of the year. It's not a typical dancehall sounding tune, but it definitely has a very catchy factor about it. I love the back and forth between Spice and Conscience on this. Russian provides a solid instrumental for the pair to work with, and I think the way that the hook is delivered definitely gives it a center stage feel. This is one of the leading tracks off the album. I think it's the most streamed track off the album prior to release date, and it still packs a real punch. There's a reason why this one is super popular. Definitely one of the catchiest hooks of the year. I have got notes in front of me just so I'm not forgetting what I'm saying in case you're wondering why I keep looking down. From this, we then jump right back into the more dancehall sort of classic sound with a wicked tune that goes by the name Purple Touch. This has a real old school rave feel about it, really energetic in Conscience's performance. And it does kind of take us back to that sort of more typical dance floor sound, toasting and selectors and sort of basement parties. That's the sort of vibe I get off this one. You know the video for Get Busy, Sean Paul? That's what I imagine when I hear this tune, which is a bit of a strange one, but there we go. Following that then, we get into the Toxic interlude, which gives us a bit of a respite from the general track listing. This one, just kind of letting him kind of riff with some auto-tune expression. It's quite nice, to be honest with you. So, moving forward from that, we then get into a bit more of an emotive journey with It's Sexy, as Conscience takes a more stripped-back instrumental to work with, and he explores big vocals again, groovy sort of rhythmic maneuvers as well, and it's something a little bit different, and I'm liking the fact that throughout this project, it's not just straight one thing. We do get to see Conscience explore different sorts of sounds and different sorts of energies, and that's what you're supposed to do with an album project. I think a lot of people make a mistake of doing one genre on an album. Outside of realistically grime and sort of liquid D&B, it's quite rare you're actually able to get away with one genre for an entire album project and it not get boring. So I'm very happy with the fact that he was able to expand what he does. And then after that, we then move into another one, Take a Shot. Again, this one is an angry driver's anthem for me. Very sort of trap inspired drums, a bit quicker than a typical trap tune, but those booming 808s do give this one its power. And then we are kind of speeding through this, but I don't want to linger too much on each individual track. I'd like to talk about it as an overall project, to be honest with you. From here, we then move into another interesting collaboration. No Style, this one welcoming Kamar Hykon for a tidy back-to-back vocal display. Again, this one that gets us allows us to kind of see Conscience's more raspy vocals, and he kind of utilizes that element of his vocal structure really well on this one, and the pair work back and forth really, really well. Something that I have noticed about this project though, which sadly is something which I kind of expected when I saw that it was 18 tracks and it has kind of rung true, is that I feel a couple of the tracks aren't really necessary. I definitely think this would have worked better as kind of like a 12-13 track project rather than an 18. It definitely feels like there are a couple of album fillers on there, which is completely normal to do. It does kind of make the overall feel of the album a little bit lesser than it could have been, however, but again, that's just my personal sort of approach to it. I prefer with an album project to have sort of 13 solid bangers than sort of 18 and five of them I'm gonna forget, you know. But yeah, a couple of the tracks I feel aren't necessarily necessary, which is a weird thing to say. I think Less Is More is one of these tunes. I just don't think it really stands out. It's quite kind of throwaway. There's nothing particularly wrong with it, but in comparison to the sort of high points of the album, this doesn't really hit anywhere near those. And then following that, we get into a very interesting tune, Eye Contact. This one actually goes over the Every Hustler rhythm, I believe, which is one of my favorite rhythms of the year. And I think Conscience does a pretty good job on it. But, I mean, for me, there's one sort of clear winner on this rhythm, which is Louis V Sneakers, TJ's cut on it. And I think that is one of the biggest dancehall tunes of the year. If you haven't already, do go and check that out. I'm pretty sure it's the same rhythm, unless I'm very much mistaken. I did listen to both to make sure it was, and I'm pretty sure they are the same rhythm. But yeah, very, very cool. Then we move forward again into what I believe is quite a monumental collaboration as we welcome the magnificent vocals of Jesse Royal along for a thrill ride on Just Life. Now, I'm a massive fan of Jesse Royal. I love what he does. I love the approach he takes vocally, and I love just the energy he tends to bring to tunes. Really, really like this one. Something a little bit different in the structure as well. Not a typical dancehall tune, not a reggae tune. It's something very much in between, but it really, really works. Two more collaborations next as we continue to move towards the end of the album. First up, a bit of Latin flavor, some really cool kind of drum rhythms going on She Got It, which features Rafa Pabon. Again, cool collaboration. I'm loving the international feel of this album. Following that, we then get into a more sort of futuristic funk fest with Cold Hearted Girl. This one alongside the very sultry vocals of Kaylin Castle. Again, she adds a whole different element to this tune. Something very different, and it adds a different direction for the album, giving the whole project a little bit more depth. And it's a very likable tune as well. This is one that kind of stands alone, very much in its own field compared to the rest of the track listing, but it's a cool addition to have. I'd actually quite like this this one to have appeared a bit earlier on the track listing, just to kind of showcase that variation rather than sort of throwing it on at the end. Finally, we then get into a bit of a sentimental send-off with Can't Stay Sober. It ties the project together nicely with a stripped-back combination of plucked guitars and electronic drum sounds, allowing Conscience to kind of riff vocally and give off something a little bit different and a little bit more heartfelt towards the end. I enjoyed the project overall. A couple of things. Definitely a case of less could have been more. I definitely think there's a few tracks on here that aren't really necessary. I don't think the Dre Island collaboration kind of matches up to the other collaborations. There's nothing wrong with it, but it's not perfect. I don't really understand what the Toxic Interlude did, to be honest with you. I definitely think less is more could have gone. And there's a couple of others on there that aren't really necessary, in my honest opinion, but the general track listing is solid. It's a good display from Conscience again. I'm loving the international feel that runs throughout this album project, and I definitely like the fact that he is able to kind of expand, especially on tracks like Cold Hearted Girl, She Got It as well. It's Sexy again, something a little bit different, and I love the collaboration with Jesse Royal. I'd say the collaboration with Jesse Royal and Pay For It are the two highlights for me. But I definitely really, really like Gunhead as well. A proper rave anthem, that one. Overall, solid. As an album listing, I don't really want to give it a rating out of 10 or out of 5 because it could get misconstrued and there are tracks that I could like further down the line. Overall, a solid piece of work, and it's going to be interesting to see how this one is actually received by Conscience fans and the general sort of dancehall community as well. It should be very fun to see. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this album review. I most certainly did. I've had a great time doing this one and obviously writing down all the notes and getting very busy with it. If you did enjoy, please make sure that you are getting involved with the channel by hitting the subscribe button on the right hand side of the page. And if you want to do more, want me to do more of these album reviews, I'll be doing them on newer albums rather than older albums. So if an album drops and I want to sit down and talk about it, that's what I'm going to do, rather than kind of going back into the past and focusing on albums that have already been around for a hot minute. So there we go. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this, and that's it from me. I think I'm pretty much done now for the day reaction wise. There's 3 new reactions up on the channel, so do go and check those out, and we shall see you all next time. Peace.
But it's on in a bright and tall.
Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel right now, Cub Cam TV. Stay locked.